What's up, man? Yo, how's it going? Welcome, YouTube viewers, Twitch streaming viewers. Today is the 353rd day making Songbringer. Today I'm fixing some bugs, getting ready for a beta update tonight. So I was going to do a playthrough today, but there's too many bugs to do a playthrough. There's just some really critical things. I mean, I've changed a lot in the game engine this last 10 days, getting these puzzles ready. And some other 3D things and stuff like that. So it's just like, oh, there's so much stuff that has to get all swept under the rug or at least like cleaned up somehow before I can get the update finished or even do a playthrough. So I'm shooting to work as hard as I can today and get the update released tonight and maybe do a playthrough tomorrow. But what I'm working on now is the elevators. The Z ordering was all messed up. And so I'm working on getting the Z ordering to be somewhat fixed. I've almost got it finished. So the Z ordering is all fixed going upward elevator, but downward elevator, there's still some bugs, as you can tell. But yeah, it's getting better. So, you know, it might take all stream actually to finish this, because this is some twisty shit, man. This is some spaghetti code. This is horrible code. I wrote this a long time ago, but that's no excuse. But anyways, it's really slowing me down at this point because there's so many different phases that are going on there in that elevator thing. There's like there's a phase where he walks to the point. There's a phase where he starts elevating. There's a phase where he fades out, fades in, and then he finishes the elevator. There's like five different phases or whatever, and they all have different functions. They all have different positions where it's setting the player, and it's all kind of a mess. But for me to change much of it would break so much else, so I'm just trying to kind of fix it up, patch it up as it is, so it's just taking a long time. But there's one little last thing that I'm noticing with this elevator up, and that's, you notice when this lid or whatever this thing is that the player rides for the elevator, it's sitting nicely on top of the floor, but when I get to the when I get finished with all this, in fact, let me slow down time to make sure we can see this. When I get finished with it all, it won't quite be right, and Jib's not there too. Jib's not there until the end. That's the most important part. Okay, so that's the first thing to fix is Jib. He doesn't have his Z ordering correct until he finally gets up there. And I think I see why. Jib has automatic Z ordering. Which is probably just wrong. I can't think of any reason why Jib needs that anymore. I'm gonna take that off. Hey, what's up, T? Welcome, man. How you doing today? Nice. That time Jay was fine. Okay, I'm thinking this is a good move to keep that off because I think that broke him in other ways. Yes, one more little thing done. Okay, the next thing I want to do is just a tiny little touch, but you can see that the lid of the elevator right there is underneath the back. And it needs to be up there at the right height. Which function is this? This is fade in, right? I want to go to elevator up. Avast! What's up, salad dogs? Okay, I think this is unnecessary. Where does it set the exits? What's up, TM? How you guys doing? Have you been watching pirate shows or something, Salad Dogs? It might be the actual entity because I'm not seeing anything in here that is that would change the Z order for just that lid thing. Let me start cleaning this up though. We don't need all this stuff that's commented out. This is all old. Thankfully, the system's a little more simple than it was. That's the thing, it's come out of nowhere. You just pirate all of a sudden. Yes, you love bug fixing? Awesome. Well, that's what I'm doing today. Totally bug fixing. Glad to do things that you love, man. Because I love it too. Yeah, maybe it's just the entity. Let's go to the entity.txt. So there's two, this is crazy confusing too. There's two different actual entities. There's an entity for the overworld's entrance, and then there's an entity for the dungeon entrance. So the overworld entrance, the lid is this bit here, that one entrance. I got Z order mid minus 16. And in the dungeon, it's mid minus 16 as well. So that's probably not it. Why is it? Wait, what if this was like 10? I know, this has been driving me nuts for a long time. You guys, you've probably seen this before where Songbringer, when you would go down an elevator, the floor would all of a sudden like be above some grass that was on top of it or something. This is Z ordering issue's been here for a long time. So this is really nice to get this all settled. Hey, that worked! Oh, nice. It was just the Z order. Now Jib just disappeared because he's doing some pathfinding wrong here, but I don't think that has anything to do with the elevator. Okay, good. Everything is nice. Oh, yes. Very cool. Okay, now it's time to start fixing this phase. This thing's all crazy messed up. But I think it might actually be wise to check in at this point because I've done so much already. Nah, you know what? I'll just do one big clean check-in because this is all related. So, what's up, Platformer Labs? It's going good, man. How are you doing? Okay, so I first need to start the player back at the top. You'll notice if, you might notice that the elevator now uses a sine wave too. So it's just a slight, it slightly slows down when it gets to the top and it slows down when it reaches the bottom. So that's pretty cool. Jib, you're talking when your animation's stuck. What's wrong with you? I can't fix that bug too. Okay, so I'm gonna save here. And start riding this elevator down, fixing that downward motion. So first off, there's a problem with the coloring. Oh, and the Z order. Shit. That sucks. Because the shadow is now on below. You get everything working and then there's one little thing that doesn't work. This is like, what do I do? I just spent all morning getting this fixed. If I try and change this again, this is gonna take me all the rest of the day. I won't even get to the other bugs I have to fix. See the problem right here? The shadow is not on top of this, but it makes everything else work well. The problem is if I fix it and the shadow goes. The shadow is correct. Then if there's ever any grass right here, the grass will suddenly just be underneath. This sucks. This totally sucks. But I gotta just, you know what? I think I'm just gonna go and finish what I just did. Finish all the code I've been working on. There's really nothing else I could do right now. I guess I just have to deal with the fact that these shadows are gonna look like crap. Wolfski, what's up, man? How you doing? It's been a while. How's everything been going, man? You looking for an internship? Cool, man. Do I like Dark Souls? I haven't really played it much, but yeah. I think if I take away this lip there, it's already got a lip in this other place. Oh, I just gotta relax. Somehow I will fix this so that the shadows work, the grass will work, the Z-ordering works for everything. I guess I could make it so there's never any grass. But then if there were a... Game design is good? Yeah. Drink some tea? I just drank some tea. Okay, so that covered up got rid of too many pixels. Fixing bugs today. Getting ready for a beta update tonight. Wait a minute, maybe this is off by one pixel. Maybe it's just a pixel off. Looks like it's a two pixels off, one to the right and one up, so it needs to come down and to the left a pixel. That would be entrance, back, and its position would be negative 4 and 0. Almost? Did that almost work? Well, why is that still wrong? Oh yeah, that is just right. I need to go one more pixel down. Okay. I guess there's still a few pixels that are shining through from below or something. Or it's the shadows. Could be the shadows. Okay, I shouldn't be worrying too much about this. This is kind of nitpicky. I think it's the shadows that are on top of that. Okay, first things first, let's gotta get the player so he doesn't get all crazy at the very beginning there. Let's see that slower. So he instantly changes his Z order and things get messed up pretty fast there. And the tube part here. Z order low. Let's do Z order low plus 10. We'll put it above the shadows. All right, so what is going on? With this flux when it starts. This is elevator down. Sets up the hero's position. Okay, I'm gonna make this clear. Start high was always a bad variable name because because both of them could be interpreted as being starting high. So I'm gonna do this arriving. Arriving equals this. Arriving, arriving, arriving. That'll make that easier to read. Now let me get rid of this code. It's just absolutely unnecessary now. Entrance path, changing that. We don't need that. Oh, here, I think this is the problem. I'm setting the auto Z layer for the player. Let's get rid of that. Okay, that should help. One thing at a time, one thing at a time. Oh, cool. Nice. The player did look right there for the beginning. Something crazy happened after the start of the next thing, though. That might have to do with fade in. Elevator down. Old hero pause. No, that should be okay. I think. All right, I'm gonna see it in slow motion, and I'm also gonna look at the numbers and everything that are exported to the log. Check it out. Slow-mo. Oh, Jib was wrong. That time it didn't mess up as much. Oh, it's because it was in fast forward. Okay, let's look at this data. Trying to figure out what's going on. So the first phase, flux phase now 16. It starts. This is where he walks to the position up here. And this is where he's going to start elevating down. So this is the player's position. Starts at Z0, goes to Z negative 47. So that's why this works well. This is that these numbers are correct. Just goes down to negative 47 on Z. And then the next thing doesn't have anything for Jib. And it doesn't even set the Z right for the player. But then all of a sudden, oh. Wait, so what phase is this? Phase four, this is fade in. Should be fade in. Zero, one, two, three, four. That's fade out. Okay, that's fade out, which means this is fade in, fade out. Let's teleport out. Fade out doesn't do anything special, so must be fade. Oh yeah, fade out, of course, it's gonna stay at negative 47. That's great. And then we got flux phase now, 5. This is where the player starts. Fading in. Oh! Okay, it's not the fade in that needs the negative Z and all that. Hey, what's up, Zanger? All right, so both of these need to be V3F 0, 0, 160. Yeah, so during the whole fade in, the player's Z position is the same. And then it's only once it gets to elevator down that it starts using the negative z, or it starts interpolating its z position. Yes! Oh, finally we have the elevator almost working. Yeah, it worked almost! Man, it's been so long. Okay, the player's position is too high. Okay, so this. This needs to be. I think it needs to be minus elevator. Yes. John 19, Steve Trevi. Almost only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades. Totally. I never heard that saying, but it totally works. And in this context, it works very well. So if I subtract that, that'll be adding. Okay, let's see if that works. Lots of bugs, man. Lots of bugs left to fix today. This is just the one bug, the elevator bug. I got other things that gotta get done, but I'll get it done. I'll get this update released to Steam tonight, and then tomorrow I think I'll do a playthrough, or maybe I'll take the day off. I don't know. Nice, let's see that again. Yes, except for Jib. Jib's bad right there, too. Oh, this is great. Almost got this finished. All right, so something happens with the Z orders when right when they start their elevating thing, Jib goes wonky. See it in slow-mo, because I'm not sure if the player does too. No, the player's fine. Jib's messed up. Ship it. He did. What was that? That was really crazy, right? I've been noticing that too. There's something that goes on where Rock does the same animation twice, or he flips over when things start. That's another little bug. This could have to do with the entity position of the back thing. The back thing has its. Well, it has no offset at all. Let's do Z order mid plus six. Right, Jib. Come on, be right this time. Oh, oh, not plus six, minus six. Oh, when I ran around the platform. Oh yeah, the bug I mentioned, check this out. If I slow down the time, watch the player. I'm holding straight up, and he's gonna flip back down. See that? Ba-bam! He goes, I'm gonna go one frame facing downwards. Yeah, oh, it worked. It totally worked. Don't know why that shadow's purple. This is like some of the most disorganized code in all of Songbringer. This is like such a bitch to update. I've been trying to fix this, just this bug, riding the elevators, since this very morning. But I think it's actually working now. Yeah, things look pretty good there. Nice. You know what? I think Steve Trammy's right. It's time to ship this. Or at least check this in. This is a good check-in point. Everything is somewhat working. Yeah, I think it's not the animation code per se, but the way the Flux system has its own system for doing animations. It's like it takes over the existing system and just kind of does what it wants. Skynet. Does it make you think it's like Skynet every time? That looks a little more organized. Oh, right, it's taking over and doing what it wants. Yep, it's Skynet. This whole fuck, you know what? This thing's way too long anyways. It's like at least 3,000 lines of code in this one file. It's definitely taking over. It's so crazy how that shadow's purple. It's like bugging me all of a sudden. Oh, we broke something. Damn it. It set visible false. Writing upwards, right? We want to be if leaving. I just noticed something. The elevator down goes to like negative 47 or whatever. If this said it were longer, I think it would be a smoother, it would be a slower movement. Thank you. No, that was way faster. So if I do, that was negative 47. What if it was like negative 27? Yeah, that was slower. That was definitely slower. Not enough. I don't think this needs Jib ID anymore either. Yep, get rid of Jib ID. I haven't ever run Xcode's Analyze. Does it work? Is it cool? Does it do good stuff? Address sanitizer. Address sanitizer? What's that? Let's do an analyze. I've never done this before. What's up, Scottish Pizza? Cool. You guys are developing an RTS? Awesome, man. Very excited. Cool. Same thing. I don't think we need Jib ID in any of these methods anymore. Yeah, you bet. That's so funny, Steve. This is like the most unperfect code I have here. This all this flux code. This whole CPP file is like my nightmare. Elevator up. All right, so elevator down. I don't know if it needs exit start pause anymore. Oh, it does. At the end. Man, this analyzer takes a while to run, huh? Okay, this stuff's looking pretty clean and good now. What else? This fade in thing that got changed. It looks like most of that's kind of how it was. I'm not gonna mess with that too much. But there are some things I changed, like in move system. I want to get a nice clean check in here. It's like I don't need to see this. What else was it? Oh yeah, was I do yeah, I might have messed it up. Oh yeah, arrive dungeon, that should be cleaner. And it should properly set the save game and all that. This should be a function. Okay, that seems to be cleaner. Was there anything else I need to do to clean up to be all ready to check this in? I got rid of this stupid disable stairs function, thankfully. Place item. Lift sword. Sprite blend point. Oh, there's something else. I want to get rid of that. Actually, that was kind of helpful. Let's comment it out. Was kind of serious though. It mostly checks the stuff you're very thorough about initializing and make sure your variables, oh, won't ever be null when calling method. Oh yeah. Three, there's three things though it mentioned. Value stored to XX during its initialization is never read. What? This is impervious to noise generate terrain. Really? So we can just comment that out then, huh? YY is used, XX is not. Hey, look, XX is used because I did this if false. This is some code I'm not even using at this point. Okay, well, this would just have, to make this better for the code analyzer, I could just do that. Sphere tile. It's like you're not using R, man. Yeah, I'm using R right there. Value stored to R during initialization is never read. I don't believe you. It's read right here, man. And it's used again right here. The analyzer messed up. Don't see any returns. Wow. Hey, score one for me. Fmod cleanup channels. Size before? Well, yeah. Hey, wait, this is another one where it is used. Oh no, this is because fmod verbosity is never greater than one. Maybe that's how this is not getting used. Because x is never not equal to width. How would you know that? Yeah, this one's wrong, man. Yeah. Value stored to R said the same thing when I expanded it. Yeah, this one's, I'm telling you, this one's wrong. Maybe it's just suggesting that I make it const or something. No, it's not. No, it wasn't because I was using it there. Size before. Now this one, I can see how that would be a static and whatever. These are not that important. These are not important. I need to go back to just building it normally. Yes, the radar abyss. That's why I never file those. But I'm secretly hoping that someone else out there is filing the into the radar abyss, and that Apple will actually do it. The one thing I'd like to see is if they would fix the freaking quick open, so that you had the option to ignore all the system files. Like if I, especially when I type PH, it gives me PHP.h. Like I'm ever gonna open PHP's headers in a C++ project? Because this is somehow part of OS X 10.11, it puts this up here. Oh, look at all these PH files. I'm never, ever gonna quickly open. No, you're not interrupting, man. Thank you for sharing something. Thank you, man. I know, I wish they would fix that. The quick open, I'm so reliant on it now. I use it all the time. It's so fast, it's so awesome. I never have to use my mouse. And I love this feature. It's just that I have to work around stuff like that. Anyways, okay, now that that is all tidied up, ready to check in, I'm gonna go check it one last time. Make sure the elevator is still working fine. And then maybe I'll tackle the next bit. You know what? I should tackle the next most important bugs rather than trying to fix it even more. But I am still bugged by the fact that you can't see your shadow on top of this thing. So I guess, yeah, I'll come back to that later tonight if I have time before I do this Steam update. But I think this is working. At least you can play the game again. At least the Z ordering's correct. Yeah, this is correct enough. It's correct enough. I'm checking this in. One last look over. I did change Jib so he doesn't have his auto Z, but that's pretty cool. I had to play around a lot with the Z ordering of everything related to these entrances. That's a new color mixer, so the color of the floor looks better there. I improved the Flux CPP a little, simplified things a bit. This is cool. It uses a sine wave when it's doing the elevator now, so it looked cool. It like looks like it's slowing down when it gets to the bottom. A lot of functions moved or created simple small functions. So I'm not reusing code everywhere here. Got rid of that monstrosity. Simplify these elevator functions. I did change the way input locked works. That actually fixed the elevators were jittering. Like you would when you would ride the elevator, it would jitter, 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 jitter. And that was just as simple as changing the move system so it didn't edit the player's position when it's already edited from the flux thing. Oh yeah, render component has the original Z order layer now, so Z order layers can be restored, which is going to be great in the future. Oh, and shadow components have a different Z order now. They're like just above low. Okay. Whew, let's check this in. Whew. All right. Despite the bugs that still remain in that code, that's actually looking pretty good. Let's get to what's the other important things on my list are these. You shouldn't be able to buy a cactus until you have a pouch. Let's go to a store. The remaining bugs on my list should actually be way quicker than fixing all that. Thanks, Sir Momster. All right, so what do we got here? This should be a cactus, I think. Do I have any cactus pouches? Yeah, I got a cactus pouch. That if it is a cactus, that's not. That can't be a cactus. Let's try the next door. All right, cool. We got a cactus. Let's see. Okay, so if I didn't have the cactus pouch. No cactus pouches. I should not be able to purchase that. Thanks, Sir Momster. Yeah, so it's still allowing me to purchase this. No problem. I will make it so. I think it's create items is where it kind of filters its list of things it can sell. Is store Z bomb? Like, where does it say? You can't purchase bombs. Yeah, here is, this is it. If oh, wait, no, that's the purchased already. Jonah, what's coming up in the latest beta update? Dude, so much. But in general, there's swordless dungeons now. There's dungeons where you fight, or you don't even fight really. You have no sword, you don't have jib, and it's mostly puzzle based. So it's like using your thinking and stuff. Like, you know the sand dungeon I've been having in there for a long, long time and saying this is not how I meant it to be. I finally finished the sand dungeons. So the sand dungeons are sweet. Zero is a new NPC. Zero is the guy with the big horns, big bullhorn guy. That guy is in now, and he's all mysterious. He appears and stuff, and he disappears. There's a new Brutus NPC. Brutus gives you the biodetector. So instead of there being two mini boss encounters at the beginning of the game, there's one mini boss encounter, and there's one random NPC encounter. So that's kind of more interesting. There's the new item, the cactus pouches. There's the meditation skill, there's the lighter item, and like I said, there's puzzles. Puzzles were the biggest work, one of the biggest works, the swordless dungeons and the puzzles, all those kind of go together, but they took a long, long time, but there, anyways, all that is in there. So puzzles, swordless, those are the biggest parts. There's something which should disallow me from buying a bomb. Oh, there is no bomb container. Oh, right. Oh, I mean, you can never just buy a regular bomb. It just converts it into a bomb. So we want to go if the player is trying to buy a cactus. Yeah, so the update's coming out tonight, probably late tonight. So it might be tomorrow morning for you or... yeah, it will be tomorrow morning for you, unless you're up super duper late tonight or whatever. But yeah, I'm excited to have this update out. This is a big one. This is a really, really big update because it's bringing this foundational concept of a swordless dungeon to light, and I hope it's fun. I really want to get you guys' feedback on this too. How does this swordless dungeon feel? It's pretty interesting. You can find secret items. There's puzzles. There's traps. And all of it you get to play without the sword. It's pretty interesting. So if item equals K, item cactus. And the player doesn't have any cactus count containers. Then continue. Don't sell this item. Hey, what's up, Arcane? Welcome, welcome. Yeah, I'm really excited to get you guys' feedback on that. So I might play on, do a live playthrough tomorrow. I don't know. Probably. If I might have to take a break. I might have to just like, yeah, I might have to take a little siesta type. Cause I'm gonna be up late tonight getting this update out. Item, let's just set the item to none. How about that? I think that's what needs to be done here. It still did something. It did like a blank white dot up there. Is that because I'm none as no image. What am I fixing? Oh man, so much. I was fixing the elevators mostly. That's mostly done now. There's still some things I need to go fix with elevators, but they're a lot better than they used to be. I'm fixing this purchasable things right now. Like now that you have cactus pouches, you shouldn't be able to buy a cactus until you have at least one pouch. Maybe I should set purchased equals true. I think that also takes the item away. Purchased. Perchance to dream. Ah, very nice. Now we have a blank entry right here. Can't buy the fear. Now we buy one of those. All right. Now, if I have a cactus container, I should be able to buy cactuses. All right. Sweet. Another bug bites the dust. Okay, next thing is the level 1 puzzles. You don't have the lighter, so I need to make sure the level 1 puzzles don't include any unlit pillar things that lock you in a room and you don't have the lighter to get out. So let's go to dungeon 1. This only applies to dungeon 1 because dungeon 2 is always the first swordless dungeon, but that won't always apply. Later on I'm going to change it up a bit. So it'll randomize what dungeons are actually the swordless ones. Ooh. so tempted to check this to make sure this works still. Oh, damn it. You see that? Oh, it's all broken. God damn it. Ah, it sucks. Well, definitely got my work cut out for me tonight. I gotta work on these elevators for another 4 hours, probably. Alright, let's get these mechanics working in these dungeons. The puzzle, let's find a puzzle. Well, I remember this dungeon. Okay, here's a puzzle. There's four pillars. They're supposed to be lit on fire. But I don't have the lighter. I shouldn't have the lighter. Let's take away the lighter. Lighter zero. There. Now I'm stuck. Totally stuck in this room. I can't get out. What the heck? Here I am. Let's put the sword. Why don't we have the sword? Sword three. Turn off God mode. Spoiler alert. Yes, this is pretty much a spoiler alert here. This is a puzzle, right? I'm solving puzzles. Okay, so we need to change this to something else other than an unlit pillar so that you can... In fact, I think I just changed it to... Where is that? Area patterns. Pattern, puzzle... This is the 1 dot, 2 dot, 4 dot. We'll make a puzzle tile. And if this is Z, area pause dot Z. Less than 2. Then our puzzle tile is going to be tile. Let's do just a regular pillar at first. Well, Momir, what's up, man? Haven't seen you in a minute. Old faces. Familiar faces. That's what I meant to say. Familiar faces. So if we are... equal to or above level 2, then we do an unlit pillar. So let's write that way. Equal to. And then we capture that. Oh, there's no need to capture. It's been a while. How you been, man? How's everything? This is puzzle tile. Puzzle tile! Okay, so that should change these to regular pillars. Yes, so sleeping at night, yes. Yeah, man. What you been doing, man? What you been doing? Okay. This is a very unobvious puzzle. This is hard to solve. Spoiler alert, I'm solving puzzles, giving away things. You doing great? Why am I not damaging this thing? Oh, I was. Oh, that broke? How many more things are broken? Okay, that took forever. I was able to get out. Bug fixing, right? Yeah, it's bug fixing day. I'm working on getting the beta update out to Steam tonight. And there's a lot of bugs because I've done a lot of foundational work on the game the last 10 days to get puzzles to work. And so there's just a lot of a lot of stuff. Wait, is it even locked? It's not locked. Oh, that's because these aren't puzzle pillars. Oh, you know what? I'm just gonna leave it like that. That way, dungeon one for now just doesn't even have puzzles. That works. That totally solves the problem. Nice. Thanks, man. Let's switch this into a one dot real quick. Okay, pattern, puzzle, one dot. I mean, four dot. Four dots becomes one dot. Just want to see what that'll look like. How did I mess up the pillars? Oh, the Z is okay, it's just that it's not showing its animation when it does its when it gets hit and stuff. And yeah, this does not lock the door. Okay. I can live with this. My plan is to have a couple different ways you can solve puzzles. There's lots of different things you can use to solve puzzles. There's gate items, they're like the lighter. But there's also gonna be pushing, so eventually you're gonna be able to push stuff, like you bit like this little thing here. You get next to it, you push it. Let's figure out why that's not doing its thing. But I can check that in. Alright, there's another little bug fixed. Now let's fix this other bug. It cropped up somewhere along the line. There's some function in collision system, activate, change HP. And here it is, anims HP to frame. Let's figure out why that's not working. When I hit this pillar, there's like eight different frames. There's like all these different frames where the pillar gets shorter and shorter and shorter. Every time you hit it, it gets smaller. And that is supposed to work, but it's not. It's not changing the frame at all. And we're getting there. We're getting into this function. Let's see what happens when I do this. Oh, it doesn't have its overwritable flag. Why is that? We got this entity. Oh, come on. Why does Xcode do this sometimes? Just like sometimes it just ditches out. It's like, yeah, I don't want to show you that variable. Nope, not even gonna show you. I'll show you some other variables. Sure, you want to see anim? You want to see K fear colors? No, but not E, not the one thing you want to see. Okay, anyways, render flags anim overwritable. Why would it have? Something is giving it the overridable flag. Or that it's taking away its overridable flag. Either that or it never starts with one. Oh. Yep. It might just be that it never starts with one. Hold on a second. Render component. Render component. Well, render component. There's this thing where it sets up the sprite and stuff. Like runs its first animation. Set data with pause. Where's that little bit where it runs its first animation? It runs the idle animation, possibly. Where is that? I'll be right back. Get a drink of water. I think k-idle is where it uses the profiles animation. Oh yeah, it calls set animation idle forever. I guess it's an init sprite. This is where it should happen. If it's successful. Start with overridable. Flags or equals k render nm overridable. I have a hunch this is going to fix the pillars. Let's see. If this isn't it, then there's some other issue why it's losing its overridable flag. Yeah, that was it. Cool. Okay, that was a quick fix. Git commit, that's render components start with overridable flag. I'm a lumberjack. Why you say that? Okay, I'm gonna move on to this next room. I just noticed there's another bug here in this room. The spiders are spawning like immediately far away from this guy. Oh, the lumberjacking the pillars. Oh, yeah, that was lumberjacking for sure. There should be trees you can lumberjack down and make some logs. Build your own hut, stay for the winter. I think this might have to do with setting the position of spawned enemies. Yeah, I'm gonna trust my instincts here. I think there's a function called create AI. Create AI does set any valid position, right? Or is this? No. Yeah, here it is. Create AI. Set valid pause. Where does this get set? Oh, here, let's do this first. If I take that away, if I make that if false, let's see if these spiders spawn all the way right next to the eye. No. Okay. It wasn't that. It must mean that the Verloc, when it spawns, oh yeah, it's using -4. Let's do 0. And cut it off halfway and go if ran smart. So there's less of them. Well, let's see, maybe around there. Less of them if you're in like level 1. They're still doing it. I think that might have broken him actually to put that in. What if I went +4? Something is when it's spawning these little spiders is putting the spiders in the in a proper position. I don't want it to put it in a proper position. I just want it to put it wherever. I guess AI system. Let's go to where it spawns. Your spawn. Oh. Your spawn. Where it does the count. Creates the AI. Let's set a breakpoint because I don't see anything obvious why it would be changing that position or whatever. Oh, it's right here. Get any valid position. Oh. I'm like, I don't see anything obvious at all. It's right here. Okay, so if I get that out of there, now let's see. All right, cool. It's putting all the spiders right there. See him coming from. Okay, so how do I do this? How do I make it so? I know this is wrong to just take this out, but like I can't think of anything else, any other spawned enemy that might need this, except for maybe the blob boss. Yeah, let's fight the blob boss. This could be it, could be something that he needs. Oh, I guess I could just do the position offset. Heck is this pause? Parse position? Yeah, if I go, if num values less than or equal to 1, So set a valid position if a specific position was not set. And for the blob boss, he spawns. Spawn some small blobs, so they have positions as well. Maybe it's just the exit that they're getting stuck on. The more you know, Hamachi does not fully deinstall itself. Wow, crazy. What's up, Machi? Right, if it had zero mask. Oh, you can play LAN-only games via internet. Oh, that's a crazy bug. Nah, that doesn't even work. Right, I need some way to just say invalid positions are okay. I guess we. Here, let's start this off. Let's make this data driven. If let's make a bool called invalid. Pause, okay. Starts false. Capture it. Check for it here. And say stir val two, one, two. All right, so the Verloc, when it spawns, all these can say spawn spied, 0, negative 4, invalid pause, OK. This might look ugly, but at least it's data driven. Now it's up to the the behavior tree whether it's okay or not, rather than up to the code. All right, now it looks better. It's a lot better. Let's see. All right, I'm just gonna leave that as it is. Oh, yeah, I guess I should test the boss. Make sure the boss still works. Damn it. It's putting a valid position there, too. Oh, good luck, Momir. Oh, I've only done 1510 myself. 1604, huh? I didn't know they had that already. Now, if I check if the area is already active here, then it will set the valid position only if it's not active already. If the area is already active, it's not going to do this automatic set valid position. It's going to trust whatever position it's given. Oh, you're doing the LTS? It's only out for 2 days? Okay, I gotta make sure the blob boss still works now. Actually, I should fight this guy, make sure he works. Why is his eye open? He's broken. I feel like I'm drowning in bugs. That time his eye was not open. I don't get it. Check the blob boss before I check us in, though. Dungeon 3, maybe. Fuck. Good, we got a blob boss. Ideas on how to improve the icon? What style of art is your game? Is this Swarmonian Explorer? Is it Swarmonian Explorer? Is it a pixel art? One suggestion would be to make the icon pixel art, or just make the icon kind of fit the style of your game, and if possible, to try and make it seem exciting, you know, like or interesting or something, you know, like. What was I trying to say? You know, icons are really, really important, but especially on the App Store, they're not as important as, you know, like, on Steam, I guess. But yeah, I don't know, I guess just try and fit the style of your game, that's all. So, maybe pixel art. Okay, that boss works fine. we can name the bugs? Yeah, name all the bugs you want. What's up, Zilton? All right, that is most of the big bugs. Actually, yeah, all of the big bugs are fixed, except for the, what's next? I want the player to be able to get into the swordless dungeon, even if they haven't got the bombs yet. I want Zero to do a cutscene really quick. Do we have enough time to do that on today's stream? Perhaps I can get this started. Let's see. Okay, so let's go to the overworld. Or zero. Zero, negative 12. So here's another bug. This is related to me working on the elevators all this morning. I must have broken something because when I walk here, it doesn't do his animation where he's walking downstairs anymore. So let's fix this. Fuck CPP. Talking about flux downstairs, which is an amalgamation of phase downstairs, phase fade out, and phase fade in. I think it's K-phase downstairs. This logic's wrong. This should be counting if you even have the sword. So count K item sword is greater than zero. And this should be if E gear ready.ka. And you have the sword equipped. E gear equip KA equals K item sword. All right, so I have the sword. It shouldn't be ready, so it should be doing render set animation stairs north sheath. Oh, the only problem is that it's allowing that to be an overwritable animation, so we need to go e render sprite. No flags. And equals render an m overwritable. I think. You're just gonna sleep, maybe? Maybe? Let me just make a list of all the names of the bugs. Cool. There's a couple hundred at least. If we have the sword, we should. Shouldn't be ready. Yeah, it's definitely running this. Stairs north. Sheath. Oh! Holy crap! Shouldn't have dash sheath. That runs with the skin, so that would add the skin to it. Vanelope, Mortimer, King Candy Peanut Butter Bear Trap. Why? Oh, I suddenly realize what it is. Restore Hero's Ease. This thing goes into the... No, that's not it. It's, weird things come to me when I'm sleepy. As do us all. I know I wrote this function already. Where did I put this? It's setting last pause. Speaking of peanut butter bear traps, don't you think it'd be a kick-ass item? It's like a trap, but it's crazy. It sounds like a cool idea, man. That's set hero movement, but now I need to apply it. Phase downstairs. Didn't work. Why? All right, Zilton. See you, man. Okay, I'm commenting this code out to see if this is the culprit. If this is what's causing the player to continue just doing his walk animation instead of doing his proper walking down the stairs animation. Oh, yeah, that was it. Okay, I must be going crazy because I just wrote this code to stop the hero movement. Man, I'm just tired of fixing bugs. It's like I'm stalling trying to fix one tiny little bug here. I might have to stop the stream here in a second, but I'll give this like 5 more minutes. I think I can fix this. Stop hero movement. That should be setting the player's position to its last position, which should make it so it doesn't run the walking animation anymore. But either it's not, or the player position gets set somewhere else. Can't think of how else to do this, but just to log out this, whatever their positions are. So I'll give it the tick. The entity number, the old position. New position. The actual position. There. All right, this is too confusing seeing every one of these, so I want to do EID equals one only. That's when it's doing its phase open. Here's where it's starting flux downstairs. Two phases, which means it's probably doing downstairs phase. Yeah, it's doing downstairs phase first. It starts it's given a flux position of 210,144 to 210,144. So okay, the flux position is correct. It never messes with those. But it does change the position. Look at this. The position starts at 212,145,0. And in the next frame it's 210,144. WTF. Well, how is it? Why? What? Okay, we got tick heroes. Phase downstairs. Okay, I'll put downstairs begin there. I could be on the, you know what, this is great because it could be on the track to fixing this one bug where whenever it starts a phase for these fluxes, it just immediately flips the player and looking a different way. I have had no idea why it's been doing this, and this could be why, this could be lead me to why it's doing that. So this is good. This is gonna be a good bug fix, and somehow it's just crashed. Here we go. Downstairs begin. 210,144. 210,144. And the player's position also 210,144. And all of a sudden, once it gets back here, it's got 145 and 212. Something weird's going on right here. It's like all of a sudden it's just nudging the player. What is doing that? Is it the move system? Maybe it's the move system. No, I said a compass direction. None, right here. Or the input. Maybe it's like inputting, getting one last. Let's see. Input, clear direction. Doesn't look like that help. Yeah, once again. Well, this is gonna have to be a mystery for now. I have to close down the stream. I'm tired of fixing bugs, but I got a whole list of bugs left to fix before tonight's release. So I need to take a nice relaxing break, get myself a dinner, just relax, get my mind off of these bugs for a minute because it's really starting to annoy me. So anyways, thanks everybody for watching. Hope you're having a great night and we'll catch you all next time. Tomorrow's a maybe stream day. I might stream, might not, because I might be just super tired from today's release. So. Yep, beta update coming out tonight, and that's it. Another beta update next week. So, catch you guys next time. See ya.